Believe it or not, VSTS is not just for .NET projects. In fact, Go developers can get a lot of value from using VSTS for DevOps, thanks to its large set of services, which are free for individuals and small teams. Jessica Deen is here to show us how Go developers can get the most out of Azure and VSTS today on Azure Friday. Welcome, everybody, to another episode of Azure Friday. I'm Erik St. Martin, and today with me, I have Jessica Deen, who's going to talk to us about all the wonders of VSTS and features that are useful to Go developers.
Absolutely. By the way, hi, Scott's friends. It's so great to be here. So yes, Erik, today I'm going to talk about VSTS and how, as a Go developer, you can take your code that is hosted out on GitHub or somewhere else, and you can bring that over into VSTS and ultimately use VSTS as a CI/CD pipeline to get your project out into Azure.
So for our Go friends who may not be familiar with VSTS, like just generically speaking, what is VSTS?
So VSTS stands for Visual Studio Team Services, and it's a tool or set of tools that you can use to implement DevOps practices. You can actually use it to host code. So if you do have code hosted on GitHub, great, you can use an external repository. If you'd like to import it into VSTS, we do also give you free private repos, an unlimited amount. And then you can also set up things like Kanban boards and work items. You can get pretty elaborate with VSTS.
Okay.
But for today, what we're gonna do is we're gonna walk through a project I've pre-created. It's actually a very well-known project in the Go and open source community. I've demoed it quite a bit. It's called Croc Hunter. It was developed by Lockie Evanson, who actually works on the Helm team. And this is an app where you can live out your dreams of hunting crocodiles.
At least it's hunting crocodiles and not hunting gophers.
Exactly, because then that would be a problem for Go. So I'm gonna click on my Croc Hunter project. And I actually have the code for all of this living out into GitHub. And we're gonna walk through how I am gonna take this Go project, I'm gonna build and push a Docker image, I'm gonna push it up to an Azure container registry, and then I'm ultimately gonna release it out into a Kubernetes cluster I have in Azure. But I'm gonna do it all from within VSTS. So first off here, after I clicked into my project, you'll notice on the left-hand side of my navigation, I only have a handful of buttons. I am using the new UI, and there'll be links probably at the end of this where people can go see where to get these features and how to turn them on.
Okay.
However, I also have hidden certain tasks that aren't relevant to me. So I mentioned that you could also use code as hosted as part of VSTS. You can set up work items and sprints and backlogs and track stuff. That's not relevant for my project today. So I actually set up where to hide that in my project settings.
So they would just appear here.
They would just appear here. You'd see code, you'd see work, you'd see tests, you'd see all these features that you hear as part of DevOps practices. But from the first part that we care about, since my code is on GitHub, I just want to build and release code that I have somewhere else. So I'm going to hit my build and release, and it's going to take me right into my summary page where I can see my CI that I've already previously configured and fired off. I can see the history of any of the times it was successful and any of the times that it failed. And if I click into the most recent build, I can see the progression, including any of the logs. So let's take a look at how I set this up, how I set up my continuous integration or my build within VSTS. You have a few different areas. You have tasks, you have variables, triggers. All these different features really give you rich powers. But to get started is actually a lot simpler. All you really need is tasks. So under the build process, you see that I set a name, and then I have what's called an agent queue. So an agent queue is actually a set of systems that VSTS gives you. They're hosted, we take care of everything, and they're set up to build or release your pipelines. So they run the tasks that you later define in your phases.
Now, can you run this on your own infrastructure?
You can, you absolutely can. So down here, you would also have private, and you can set up your own agents on whatever build servers you have. And the more you get into this kind of configuration, I do recommend setting up your own build servers, because our hosted servers are stateless. So each time you build a Docker image and it has to pull layers, those aren't going to be cached for the next subsequent build. If you use a private agent, obviously they will. So the next step you'll see is get sources. I can see a wide variety of where I can get my code from. I have GitHub selected, and I've already authorized my GitHub account and repository. Okay. The next is just the set of tasks that I'm going to run. These are all tasks that I would run manually, but VSTS is going to automate for me. So by default, you can see that the first task I have is Docker. So if I wanted to go search for tasks, I would simply click the plus. which will take me to the marketplace, and I can search for things like Docker or Helm and add tasks accordingly. I hover over, hit add, and I'm done. But for today, I'm just going to show you the tasks that I've already added. So here's a build image task. I've specified that I'm going to use an Azure container registry, though if I had a container registry somewhere else, I could easily select that. I select the subscription where the container registry lives. I select the container registry, and then I choose the action. The next few steps is what I'm going to tell the Docker file to do, or the Docker task to do. So I'm going to tell it where my Docker file is. I can use the ellipses to manually search my directory and find the Docker file, or I can use a wildcard search that'll recursively search my directory and select my Docker file. The next thing I have is build arguments. So this particular Docker image, which is building a Go application, actually, if I go over to Visual Studio Code, you'll see here on line 17 and line 5, I have an argument and environment variable that's going to capture my VCS or my Git SHA reference and bake it into my Docker image. So VSTS allows me to pass variables from the pipeline and pull them over into my Docker file and build the image accordingly. You can also take a quick look at my Go application, which again is a super simple HTTP website, just a static application. So I'll switch back over to my VSTS image. So the next step is where I just choose an image name. I choose if I have any image tags, and that's about it. The final steps are pretty straightforward because push an image is just the same. I fill in the same information for my container registry and my Azure subscription. The only difference is the action is push an image. So I can see that right here. The next steps are all Helm tasks. So I'm going to actually take this image after it's built, and then I have charts in the same directory that's going to package up my Helm charts and hand that off for my release. So you can see that since it is a hosted agent, I have to prep my system up. So I add in an install Helm task, which is going to install Helm. It's going to initialize Helm on the hosted agent locally. And then it's going to actually run the Helm package command, where again, you can see where I'm connecting my Kubernetes cluster this time, not a container registry. I choose the subscription, I choose the resource group, I choose the cluster, and then under command, I choose the package command. So all this is under phase is just task runners. All the tasks I would manually do, I have VSTS do.
Now, if you were running on your own agents, you wouldn't necessarily need all of the installing Helm. This is just because those basically are clean slate every time your agent comes up.
Exactly, because I don't have this is a hosted agent, so I don't have anything persistent or configured that knows my authentication to my Kubernetes cluster. The final step is a drop step where I'm actually going to publish the tar file that I created from the package step. I'm going to publish it out into something that my release can go out and grab. And so we will be able to see that in the release stage. So I'm going to go ahead and hit Q, and we'll actually kick off a build so you can see this. I can double check and make sure I do want to run this on a hosted Linux preview, which I do, and I'll simply hit Q. After this fires off, it's going to go off and run all these tasks for me, and you can kind of watch as it completes. But the next cool thing is not only can I watch and see as it completes, I also have a continuous deployment trigger set up that's going to automatically fire off my release. So it kind of creates this domino effect of a pipeline. So we're just going to wait for the request to be queued, and then afterwards it starts running through the tasks.
And now, can you have this triggered based off of a Git commit, for
yes.
instance, so that this pipeline starts running the second you commit something?
You absolutely can. So this is actually already listening to a GitHub change, so I could go over and make a change here. I wanted to kind of show that you can also manually kick it off, and you can do things after you've set up your tasks. But if you have your code on GitHub, or you have it in a VSTS Git repository, either way, when you do a Git push, it'll fire off your build, it'll also fire off tests if you have, and then it'll ultimately hand off to release based on if it passed the build.
Excellent.
So you can see as this goes through and builds an image, and while it's building, we're going to go ahead and take a look at our releases so we can see how our release pipeline actually looks pretty identical to our build pipeline. So we'll see that I have a pipeline that I've already built. I'll click into it, and just like on how build, I can see the success rate, I can see visibility into the success or failures of my releases. And if I click on the ellipses, I can edit and see what tasks I'm going to tell the release to run. The first thing is that I'm going to tell it to grab the artifacts, the stuff that I published from the drop folder. It's going to publish over in my CI where I want to pull artifacts. That's going to have a continuous deployment trigger, which is set up right here, and it is enabled, that's going to kick off the release into this environment. And again, just like on how my build, where I set up an agent phase and I set up a queue, I told this to run these tasks, again, on a hosted Linux preview. And then just like on the build, I'm installing Helm, I'm initializing it, and then this time, rather than running a package command, I'm actually running an upgrade command. And this is unique because aside from setting up my Kubernetes cluster, which I don't have to do again, I just click the dropdowns and select whatever the resource group is. In this particular command, I'm able to specify a separate namespace so I can make sure I implement best practices and keep things isolated. I can use the upgrade command with a file path, but then even more importantly, I can actually use arguments where I can set really important information that's going to override my values file so that I can set things like my pull secrets and my private registry information over to my ACR. So I have this automatically, dynamically creating a pull secret for this deployment, and it's going to grab, you can notice right here, I'm going to hover, it's going to grab a password for my Azure Container Registry. I can set that password in an encrypted format under variables, and I can set that value right here with the lock that'll make sure that it's not plain text. So once that kicks off, it'll end up deploying. If we click back into releases, by now we should see that the release has kicked off, if not completed, which it has. Build 14 was actually the latest release. So if I click into the Croc Hunter application and I refresh it, I can see my commit ID from VSTS, and we'll just zoom in here. I can see the release is my channel 9 go VSTS. And I can also see the host name, which is the pod that this particular rendering is running on. Now, this is really powerful, but it's not as powerful as if you're just getting started. Microsoft and Azure actually has something that's even more powerful that ties into VSTS. We recently announced DevOps projects, and even more recently, we've also added Go support. So if you don't have a Kubernetes cluster on AKS, or you don't have an Azure Container Registry, or you don't even have a VSTS account, and you don't want to have to set up all these things manually and add in all these tasks, we can do it for you with a Go application. So you would get started from your Azure portal, and you click Create a Resource. From here, you can actually scroll down and hit DevOps Project. It's one of the popular items that's selected. It always cracks me up because DevOps is popular. I love it. I was never the popular kid in school. So under here, you can start with a fresh application, and we're going to give you sample code to get started. So we support a wide variety of languages, including, down at the bottom, we'll see Go. So we'll select Go.
Or is it at the bottom, though?
You know,
We need to talk to somebody.
We need to talk about placement. Also, I will say I have zoomed in, so certain things kind of got moved around. However, now you can choose your application framework, which will just go with a simple Go web application. Next, we hit service. And here we have a few different services we can choose to deploy this application to as far as infrastructure.
Now, this is just configuration for what your CD pipeline is going to do.
Well, and this is actually configuration for what Azure is going to set up for you. So if you don't have...
Provision it for you as well.
It will provision it and everything. If you don't have a Kubernetes service, it'll create your cluster, it'll create your registry, it'll create a VSTS account if you tell it to, and it'll create your pipeline. So we'll choose Kubernetes service, hit next, and the final step is where you can choose it to create a VSTS account if you want to, or you can use an existing one. So I'll go ahead and use an existing account, which I'll use this time just to test. And then for this, you can give it a project name. So I'll just go ahead and label it Channel 9 Go Live Demo. And the final step is, do I want to name the cluster the same thing, which I do for simplicity, and then you choose the location. You hit done, and that's it. Azure's going to create your entire DevOps project custom tailored for Go, to the point where you can actually go, this is going to be the final landing page, and you can actually see your CI/CD pipeline, your build information, complete with deep links. It's going to take you back over into a VSTS account. You can see, again, the same kind of build process, the same information that I had configured. But what's even cooler is if you click edit on some of these things, you will notice that the tasks almost identically match the ones that I manually set up. So if we go back over to the landing page in Azure, this is the page that you get after it finishes replicating. You'll see also where it'll give you a private repo. And it sets up your simple application with an external endpoint, and it's already configured ingress and HTTP routing for you. It's even configured, and it's even configured application insights. The even cooler thing is let's say you wanted to get started with your own code today. Under that build that it provisioned for you, you can click Get Sources, and change from VSTS over to GitHub and add your own account and your own code, and you already have a pipeline.
Oh, that's awesome.
It's incredibly powerful.
I mean, what are you going to do with the rest of your day after?
Drink a lot of coffee, or for any Java developers, install a lot of Java into my body. It's going to be awesome. So, yeah, I mean, pretty much that's about it. I will say, though, that if anybody's done this for the first time, or especially from the Go community, please reach out and tag us if you deploy your first VSTS account. That would be awesome. I definitely want to know about that.
Well, thanks so much.
Thank you. Thank you for having me. Thanks, Scott's friends.
Today, we were learning all about continuous integration and delivery using VSTS for your Go projects on Azure Friday.